Hello everyone, welcome to today's video. In today's video, I am going to continue a series that I started a few weeks ago, focusing on using PayHip to set up your digital shop. If you haven't watched any of those videos, I'll leave a link to the playlist that contains all of the videos in this series so you can go ahead and watch them before watching this one. In today's video, I'm going to talk about product sizing, meaning how your product is displayed on your website. There are many different sizes that are available, and some of you might already have mockups of your digital products that you have created for other marketplaces such as Etsy or Gumroad, and you wanna know if it would work for PayHip. Or if you're in the process of creating brand new mockups, what sizing works for PayHip, what sizing works best? That's what I'm gonna cover in today's video. I have my demo PayHip website up here. And if you've watched my previous video, this is the same website that I started building from scratch. If you are in your dashboard page, go ahead and click on Launch Your Store Builder. In the previous videos, we set up the header area and the footer area. We haven't quite developed the home page. That's something we would cover in a future video. In today's video, what we're going to talk about is how the product is displayed here. So the homepage is where currently the collection exists, and mine is displayed like this because I set it up this way when I was creating the digital shop. This is the default setting that came with the collection. What I'm going to do is show you how you can modify this. So to do this, we're going to start by clicking on collection. The first section in the collection is the settings. And the first option is to adjust the aspect ratio. This is how your product is displayed. The website can adapt to your product size or force it to display a product based on the size that you want. And I would encourage you to use the specific sizes, because what happens is if you upload photos or mockups with different sizes, then your website might not look as uniform or tidy. If you force it to use a specific size, then regardless of what your size is of your photo, it always shows the same. Alternatively, if you know that all of your mockups are going to be the same size, then you can go ahead and use adapt, meaning that it doesn't really matter anyway. For the demo today, I'm going to show you what it looks like based on what you select. So the first one is a square. And as you can see, for my specific design, it doesn't work because I'm using the dimensions that I use for my Etsy shop. However, if you're going to create new mockups and you want them to look square because that's what works for your product, then of course you can use this. The next one would be the 3x2. My mockups for Etsy are 3000 by 2500 pixel, which is a rectangle shape. So selecting this works for the mockups that I already have. This is a vertical mockup, and this works if you are selling things like maybe an ebook, for example, or PDF digital downloads, and you want to display the page. So this is more in that shape. So this would work for you. The next one is 4x3, and this is similar to the 3x2. It's a rectangle. This is cutting off a little bit right here, so it's probably not the best for my product. If you look back at the 3.2, you can see it displays the entire mockup, but a 4x3 cuts it off a little bit, so this would not be ideal. But this might work for you if, of course, your mockups are already created this way. And then we have another one that is also vertical. This is a 3x4. The 3x4, just like the other 2x3 vertical, works for products that are vertical, so ebooks and PDFs like I mentioned before. This also works well for Pinterest. If you wanted your images to be Pinterest friendly, meaning that you can create them here and share the link directly from your PayHip to Pinterest, this might be a great option because this would be an acceptable image size for Pinterest. And last but not least, this is a white screen. This also works for rectangular mockups. If you're a website designer, you wanted to display the images of your website, this would be perfect. The take-home message with the images is you have to think about what product you're selling and how you want it displayed. If you've already created mockups, you might want to match the size of the mockups that you have from another marketplace if you are moving them over to PayHip. So I'll change it back to 3x2 standard, which as you can see matches perfectly with the mockups that I use for Etsy. And I'll show you a few other things. Then what I'll do is upload a new product, and I'll show you what it looks like using one of the vertical images. You can also change how many products are shown per row. So I only have three products here, which is why all three are displayed, even though four is checked off. Let's change it to two, and you can see that we have two displayed. The next thing I'm going to cover is the product page setting. So what we just did was change the setting of the collection, but there's something else that we can change related to image, and that is the product setting. So if I were to click on this, I'm automatically taken to the product page. By the way, you can either click on the product image or click on the drop-down menu. You see the option of product page and just click on whatever product you want. It doesn't matter because you can change the setting of one product and it would affect the rest of them. I'll click on the habit tracker spreadsheet. And as you can see, instead of editing a single page, you can say edit all product pages at the same time. So I'll go ahead and click on that because what I want is to make changes to the product setting globally as opposed to one individual product. And it will tell you, are you sure? And if you're sure you want to make a setting change to all of the products, click on start editing all. Now that we're here, you can see that because my image is this rectangle form, it maintains that shape here on the left-hand side. And on the right-hand side, this is where you can find the title, add to cart button, as well as the product description. I don't have a product description here, but if I had one, you would see the product listing description shown here. What I'm going to do is go back and add a product description because I want to show you what it looks like with one. All right, so as you can see, I have added description to this specific product, and this is what it's looking like so far. I'm not a fan of how it looks with the photo taking up more than half of the page, and then you have this product description on the side and it's a little bit narrow. So you can play around with that. To do this, click on product and you'll be taken directly to the product setting. The first option would be to change the image width. If you feel like the product width is too much at 55%, which is the default, you can change it to something lower. So maybe 45%. And as you can see, now we have more space for the description. And what I would recommend would be to keep the description succinct. That way it's not taking up too much vertical space. And I am guilty of this. Some of my descriptions are not succinct, so it does look like this, but I will make some changes to my specific website just to make sure it looks better. The next option would be to change the display of images. If you have multiple images like I do in this product, you see that with the carousel option, the customer can click on the arrow and go back and forth to view all of your images. If you wanted to change how it's displayed, click on carousel. You can change the slideshow where details are displayed on the left-hand side and you have the main photo that's selected on the right-hand side. You can also change it to horizontal, so have the thumbnail images displayed at the bottom. Changing the option to stacked, this is another way to have the images work for you if you have long product description. That way the images cover the entire page and matches the vertical space that your description covers. I do have this setting in some of my products, so this is an option if you didn't want to shorten your product description. The third option would be stacked to column. This is similar to what we have before, but instead of having all of the images displayed in their full size, we have it displayed in two columns. And the last option, of course, is carousel, which is the default that comes with the product setting. I did promise to show you what it would look like with vertical images. So what I've done is to add two products with vertical images, demo one and demo two. So we'll go back to the dashboard and go back to launch your store builder and go to all of our products. And as you can see, because we chose adapt, what it's done is that it has selected the vertical option to adapt to these first two images, but then you can see that these ones don't look good, which is why I don't recommend adapt, except of course if all of the images you plan on uploading are exactly the same. So let's change this to vertical 2x3. Ignore these images. I do want to focus on the images that are vertical. This one displays perfectly because this is an ebook size. This not so much because this is more of a PDF. So if I were to change it to the other, which is 3x4, you can see that the PDF does display perfectly, as well as the ebook. And that is all I have for this video. If I missed anything, please let me know. Leave comments in the comment section. This video was created based on a comment that was left in one of my other videos. So if you are interested in me showing something else, or if you have any questions specifically related to the image settings using PayHip, feel free to leave a comment below. If you are interested in buying digital products, I will leave links to my Etsy shops and my website where you can purchase mockups to create and sell your own digital products. All right, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Take care.